now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Fairies are beings who occupy a middle realm between earth and heaven. Fairies have magical powers and are sometimes associated with demons and fallen angels. In lore, they are capable of bewitchment and possession, requiring exorcism. Fairy originates from the Latin word fata, or fate, and evolved from fairy, a state of enchantment. According to lore, fairies themselves do not like the word, they prefer to be called by more respectful names, such as the good neighbors, the gentry, the people of peace, the strangers, themselves, the seely, blessed, court, and other terms. Fairies are often referred to as the little people. In medieval times, fairies sometimes described women who had magical powers. Fairy origins. Fairy beliefs are universal and ancient, and there are a variety of explanations of their origins. Celtic fairy lore is particularly strong and absorbed Christian elements. In Irish lore, the fairies are descended from the Tuatha De Danann, the early inhabitants of Ireland. When the Mill invaded, the Tuatha De Danann used supernatural powers to become invisible and withdraw into the hills. From them arose the gods, demigods, heroes, and the fairies. Other explanations for the origins of fairies are the following. Souls of the unbaptized and pagan dead, trapped between heaven and earth. Guardians of the dead, living in an otherworld that exists between the living and the dead. They have the power to take people, and when they do, those people die. Ancestral ghosts. Fallen angels cast out of heaven with Lucifer, sentenced by God to the elements of the earth, where they act as demons. Nature spirits who are attached to particular places or to the four elements, for example, sylphs of the air, gnomes of the earth, undines of water, and salamanders of fire. Supernatural creatures who are shape-shifting monsters or half-human, half-monster. Small human beings, primitive races like the Tuatha De Danann that went into hiding in order to survive in more recent times, fairies have been compared to extraterrestrials. And characteristics. Fairies usually are invisible save to those with clairvoyant sight. They are best seen at dusk. In lore, they do not like to be seen by people and will often punish people who see them accidentally, including striking them blind. If they choose to be visible, fairies can bestow the gift of clairvoyance and healing upon mortals. Descriptions of fairies cover a wide range, from tiny lights to winged creatures and, most often, small people. They tend to be either ugly, even monstrous, or beautiful. They are shapeshifters who can assume whatever form they wish, especially to deceive or manipulate people. In Ireland, fairies assume the forms of black birds, especially crows. In French fairy lore, they are sometimes magpies. Black birds, as well as black animals, are associated with demons and the devil. Some fairies are solitary, like leprechauns, while others live in races and nations. Their homes are often in the earth and are accessed through mounds, caves, burrows, and holes in the ground and under piles of stones and rocks. It is bad luck to disturb these places, and the fairies will take revenge on people who do, causing misfortune, illness, and even death. The Land of Fairy, also called Elfland, has characteristics of the Land of the Dead. Time is altered, so that a day in human life might stretch into years in Fairyland. There is no day or night but a perpetual twilight. In legend and lore, there is an intermingling of ghosts of the dead and the afterlife with fairies and the Land of Fairy. Descriptions of European fairies have been collected from oral lore. Robert Kirk, a Scottish Episcopalian minister who was clairvoyant, visited Fairyland and wrote an account, The Secret Commonwealth, in 1691-92, still one of the major first-person accounts in existence. A major compendium of fairy lore was written by W.Y. Evans Wentz in the early 20th century, The Fairy Faith in Celtic Countries, 1911. Fairies live much as humans do, working and maintaining families and amusing themselves with food, drink, music, and dancing. They travel in the physical world along paths, tracks, and rats, which, as with their homes, must never be disturbed or destroyed by humans. Some of them like to march in processions at night and especially at the cross-quarter days of the seasons. If someone builds a house atop a fairy track, the fairies will pass right through it, and the occupants will sicken, their crops will fail, and their animals will die. The fairies act as poltergeists, opening closed windows and doors and creating disturbances similarly to haunting ghosts. Fairies are similar to demons in that many of them do not care for humans, and sometimes they will deliberately fool and attack people. A strong trickster element runs through fairy lore. They are fond of leading travelers astray. They attend human wakes and funerals and eat the banquet food, spoiling it for people. Fairies kidnap people to their abodes, especially beautiful women they take for wives. In Fairyland, a person who eats their food remains trapped in another world. To be taken by fairies means to go to the other world, also the land of the dead. If an abduction is temporary, a person sickens and then recovers. If it is permanent, the person dies and stays in the other world. Eating fairy food is taboo, for it will alter the body and prevent a person from returning to the world of the living. Not all fairies are hostile or tricksters. Some are kind and helpful to people, though on conditions. For example, the household brownies will help with chores, as long as occupants are respectful, leave out milk, cream, and food for them, and are not messy. Once food is left for fairies, it must not be eaten by man or beast, for the fairies take the essence of the food, and it is no longer fit for others to consume. If food falls on the floor, the fairies claim it, and it must be given to them. Fairies have a major weakness, iron, which repels them and dilutes their supernatural powers. Amulets made of iron keep fairies away. Bewitchment and witchcraft, as do witches, fairies have the magical ability to bewitch people and animals and to blight crops and health.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.